If you want to build a native iOS app working in Xcode, here's how to actually set up Cursor with custom rules, project context, and attach docs so it becomes a real coding assistant, not just a chatbot. Hey, I'm Daniel. I build SwiftUI apps solo and share how I use tools like Cursor and Claude to move faster and stay focused. Okay, so first things first. To build apps with Cursor, you'll definitely need the Cursor app. Simply head over to cursor.com and download it. You'll also definitely need Xcode available directly from the App Store. With both of these apps downloaded, you're all set to create a new Xcode project. I'm pretty sure you're already familiar with this, but just as a quick refresher, if you're building for iOS, select iOS and click Next. Here, fill in your product name, your team, and your identifier. Set the interface to Swift UI and the language to Swift. For testing, I usually choose None initially and add tests directly in Xcode later. If you're planning on using Swift data or core data, now is the best time to add them. Click Next, and voila, your Xcode project is ready. I strongly recommend checking out some sessions from DubDub or Paul Hudson's tutorials here on YouTube. They're extremely helpful. In this video, however, we're focusing exclusively on Cursor and project setup. My preferred way of working is placing Xcode on one side, like this for example, and Cursor on the other. This layout makes it easy to handle both apps simultaneously. You might sometimes need screenshots or manual adjustments in Xcode since Cursor isn't fully integrated yet. Maybe there's an MCP that I'm not aware of yet, but this is how I've been successfully building my app so far. So here's Cursor on the right. In the Settings tab, I highly recommend enabling YOLO mode and auto run. These options let the Cursor agent work autonomously within your project, making things much smoother. Moving on, we have the doc section right here. You can easily add new documentation by pasting URLs you want Cursor to reference. Personally, I have added Apple UI guidelines, Apple developer docs, Swift UI, and Xcode documentation. Even though most of this information is available within Apple's developer documentation, I find it easier to add Swift UI, and Xcode separately, saving Cursor the hassle of searching through everything. Just paste your links under New Docs, and Cursor will reference them directly during your coding sessions. Next, let's talk about rules. This is super important. Setting clear rules helps keep Cursor on track. I've instructed Cursor to act as a senior engineer, specializing in building highly scalable and maintainable systems. Some specific guidelines include breaking files and functions into smaller parts whenever they become lengthy. Although Cursor might not always perfectly stick to these rules, it's significantly helpful to avoid ending up with huge, messy files that become challenging to debug or understand. Additionally, there are options for planner mode, architecture mode, debugging, and GitHub integration. I'll include a link in the description below if you'd like to use my Cursor rules. With all these settings, you're fully prepared and ready to dive into coding. Finally, here's my preferred workflow. I use GPT to go back and forth, defining all the necessary features and creating a detailed PMR, project management requirements. For example, I've done this with ChatGPT for my QR code app, clearly outlining the project structure and other important details. Once this is ready, I simply copy-paste the PMR into a new Cursor rule. Cursor will prompt you to name the rule. I usually just call it PMR app, and then I paste the PMR directly into the file. This allows Cursor to easily reference the PMR whenever needed, ensuring it always has clear visibility into your project's requirements. And that's pretty much it. Now you're fully set up with Cursor and ready to start building amazing apps. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel. It really helps me grow and continue sharing content like this. If you have any questions or suggestions for future tutorials, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Happy coding!